So, good evening all of you and welcome to this session of dermatology on Let's Crack Neet PG. Now, in this session, everybody knows that we discuss one question every day and one question every minute, and the session will be for around say 30 to 60 minutes. So, I request each and every one of you to please be with me for the next few minutes. I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your Neet PG educator on an academy, and I've myself scored All India Rank 261 in my entrance examination. Now, before going ahead, I just want to tell you about an academy. This is the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG. Here we provide you live interactive sessions with a special advantage of special classes, which is absolutely free. You have quizzes, you have test series, which are present for free on an academy. You just need to unlock them, and for unlocking, you need a code which is Dr. Cheshta YT or Cheshta 10. So, any of these codes can be used to unlock the free sessions on an academy. Now, there are many important batch courses going on, among which the system-wise clinical rapid revision batch course is very important for all those who are. Preparing for the upcoming NEET PG entrance examination. Now, everybody knows that the pattern of exam have changed, and instead of giving you a one-liner questions, they are giving you more and more integrated questions where they are combining two or three different subjects together. So that is what we are keeping in mind and giving you the questions in this particular batch course. Now, this is a plus course, so you need to have a subscription of an academy. I will request everyone to get a one-month subscription of an academy plus. Use the referral code CHESTA10 to get additional 10% discount. So, the next is you have many free test series available, and the test series are started from 8 p.m., then 8:30, 9 p.m., 9:30, 10 p.m., and 5 p.m. So here these test series are in accordance to the particular exam, for example NEET PG, for example FMG, as well as next pattern examination. Now we have two type of subscriptions. Plus give you access to an academy, live classes and quizzes, while Iconic gives you access of an academy along with that of the prep ladder. So if you are in your pre-final or final year of MBBS, please get a Iconic subscription. Longer the subscription, lesser will be the per month cost if you use the code CHESTA10. And for plus, again, longer the duration of the subscription, lesser will be the per month cost. But if you are planning for this NEET PG 2021 or for the FMGE 2021, I will request you to take a 1 month subscription. Use my referral code CHESTA10. So, Sarvesh, yes, definitely I can plan a session on the image-based sessions soon. But today we have a class on one-liners of dermatology. And I have only few images today with us, but definitely I can take a session on image-based session very soon. Starting with the first question, I want everyone to answer this question because this will be a very rapid-fire session. I will be giving you 30 seconds to solve all the questions, and the remaining 30 seconds will be to discuss the related theory part. So, starting with this, I request all the students who are live with me right now, please answer this question. All are the causes of primary acantholysis except. Very nice. Please remember, primary acantholysis occurs whenever you have disruption, of intercellular adhesion molecule, which is desmosome or desmoglein. Desmosome or desmosine. So whenever you have disruption of intercellular adhesion molecule, then this is called as primary acantholysis. Other than herpes, in all three of them, you have disruption of or you have breakage of the intercellular attachment. So the correct answer of this question becomes option number one. In herpes, you tend to see secondary acantholysis, where the separation of the cell occurs because of the damage to the keratinocytes. So the correct answer becomes option number one. Very nice, Sarvesh and Sindhu. Where do you have melanocytes in the body? Can anybody tell me? In the skin, which layer consists of melanocyte? Stratum corneum, stratum basal, stratum granulosum, or dermis? Can anybody answer this question? A very easy question. Very well done. Please remember melanocyte. Total there are four type of cells which are present in epidermis. Can anybody tell me what are those four types? You have keratinocytes, very nice. You have melanocyte, you have Merkel cell, and you have Langerhans cell. Here one point which you have to remember is majority is the keratinocytes. So among the four cells, the majority is the keratinocytes, and these are present in the stratum. The melanocytes are present in the stratum basale. The Merkel cell is also present in the stratum basale, while Langerhans cell is present in stratum spinosum. So very nice, Madhavi, Sarvesh, Sindhu, everybody is right. What is the correct sequence of cell cycle? G0, G1, S, G2 and M. What is the correct sequence of cell cycle? Good. So please remember, cell cycle is a very important part. The correct sequence is G0, G1, S, G2 and then you have M. So remember the correct sequences, and here it is G0. So G0, G1, S, M and G2 is the correct sequence. Option number 1 becomes the correct answer. Very nice, each and every one of you. Now what is the thickest layer of the epidermis? I hope everybody know that epidermis is made up of many layers. Starting from the outermost, we have stratum corneum. Then we have stratum lucidum. We have stratum granulosum. We have stratum spinosum. And the last one is stratum basale. So which is considered to be the thickest layer of epidermis? Anybody can answer this question. Sarvesh, Madhavi, Sindhu, anybody can answer this question. I want each and every one of you to answer. Very nice. Please remember, stratum spinosum is considered to be the thickest layer of the epidermis. Please remember, it is not option number 1. It is option number 3, which is the thickest layer of the skin. I hope this question is clear. All of the following are the cells of epidermis except this we have discussed just now. So I expect everyone to answer this question. All of the following are the cells of epidermis except. Okay. So please remember, we have just now discussed here that there are four cells of epidermis. Keratinocytes, melanocytes, Merkel cell and Langerhans cell. I have not mentioned anything about mast cell. Please remember, mast cell, it is a part or a component of dermis. Mast cell is not a part of epidermis, it is a part of dermis. Please remember this point. This is very, very important for each and every one of you. Okay, very nice. True about corneum lucidum. So here you have more than one options correct. You have more than one option correct. So please tell me what all are the correct options in the question given above. Anybody can answer what is the correct question, what is the correct options in the question given here? Uday, Sindhu, Neha. Very nice. So stratum lucidum is a layer which is present between stratum corneum and granulosum. So option number 2 becomes correct. And please remember, it consists of degenerated cells or clear cell or also called as transitional cells. Please remember, the cells of stratum lucidum contain degenerated cells, clear cells or transitional cells. Very well done, each and every one of you. Another question given on the computer screen. Which layer of epidermis is underdeveloped in a very low birth weight infant? Very well done, all of you. Very easy question. I want each and every one of you to answer this question. Very well done. Which layer of epidermis is underdeveloped in a very low birth weight infant in the initial 7 days? And this question has been correctly answered by each and every one of you. The answer of this question is option number 4. Please remember the last layer to develop. Last layer to develop during embryogenesis. During embryogenesis, the last layer to develop is stratum corneum, and that is why the correct answer is option number 4. Very well done, each and every one of you, if you understood this. Next question. Acantholytic cells are Sarvesh, Sindhu, Uday, Dr. Madhvi. Can you answer acantholytic cells are epidermal cell, plasma cell, keratinocytes or giant cells? Acantholytic cells are epidermal cells, plasma cells, keratinocytes or giant cell. Very nice, each and every one of you. I understood that. I think everybody knows this. Acantholytic cells, whenever the term acantha is used, remember that acantha is for stratum spinosum. So acantholysis means separation of cells of stratum spinosum. And what is the name given to these cells? These are nothing but keratinocytes. So the correct answer becomes option number 3. Acantholytic cells are nothing but keratinocytes. Very well done. Which among the following is the most specific sign of nail psoriasis? Which among the following is the most specific sign? Pitting of nail, subungual hyperkeratosis, oil drop sign, splinter hemorrhages. So which among the following is the most specific sign of nail psoriasis? I want everyone to answer this question in a good number. Everybody, I'm expecting this from all of you to answer this question correctly. Very well done. Very nice. So please remember, the correct answer as given by a majority of you is option number 3. Oil drop sign becomes the most specific sign, while pitting of nail becomes the most common sign. So the question is, which is the most common and which is the most specific? So if they ask you most common, please mark pitting, and the most specific becomes the oil drop sign. Which among the following is the commonest type of psoriatic arthritis? Can you answer this question? Uday, Madhvi, Sarvesh, Sindhu. Which among the following is the most common type of psoriatic arthritis? Classic psoriatic arthritis, arthritis nutilens, asymmetrical oligoarthritis or symmetrical polyarthritis. Which among the following is the most common type of psoriatic arthritis? Which among the following is the most common type of psoriatic arthritis? Classic, arthritis nutilens, asymmetrical oligoarthritis or symmetrical polyarthritis. Very nice. The correct answer is option number 3. Psoriatic arthritis is seen in 5 to 10% of total psoriatic patient, and the most common presentation is asymmetrical oligoarthritis. Hutchison's syphilitic triad includes all except notched incisors, nerve deafness, interstitial keratitis or Clutton's joint. Hutchison's syphilitic triad include all except. Can anybody tell me the answer of this question? What does the Hutchison's syphilitic triad include? Anyone can answer this question. Notched incisors, nerve deafness, interstitial keratitis or Clutton joint. Very well done, Venkatesh, Uday, Sindhu, Dr. Madhavi, Sarvesh. Very well done, each and every one of my students. Hutchison's syphilitic triad includes all three except option number 4. Clutton joint is a sequelae of late congenital syphilis, where because of the joint pain, the patient is having swelling over the knee, and because of it, it will not move, giving rise to pseudo paralysis of Barrett. Because of pain, patient do not move, and that is why it is called as pseudo paralysis seen in the patients of Clutton joint. Early eruption of secondary syphilis are all except intensely pruritic, papulomacular eruptions, symmetrical, pleomorphic. So early eruptions of secondary syphilis are all except intensely pruritic, papular, symmetrical, pleomorphic. Can anybody answer this question? Which of the following is not seen in early stages of syphilis? Anyone? Prince, Dr. Madhavi, Sarvesh, Neha, Sindhu, Venkateshan, Uday. Very nice. Please remember, the lesions of secondary syphilis are never symptomatic. There is no itching in a patient of secondary syphilis. So option number one becomes the answer. Rest all can be seen. Symmetrical lesions, pleomorphic lesions, papules, macules, any of the lesions. Okay. So Arumima, the correct answer is option number one, not option number four. Crystalline malaria is due to obstruction of sebaceous gland, sweat gland, hair root, accessory sweat gland. What is crystalline malaria due to? Can anybody answer this question? What is crystalline malaria due to? Sebaceous gland, sweat glands, hair root and accessory sweat glands. Very nice. Crystalline malaria is obstruction to the duct of eccrine sweat glands. Very nice. It is obstruction to the duct of eccrine sweat gland. Now, eccrine sweat glands are absent in which part of the body? Palm, sole, mucosa or upper tongue. Which part of the body will not have eccrine type of sweat glands? Very nice. Uday, Sindhu, Dr. Madhavi, Sarvesh, everybody is right. Can anybody tell me, see, these questions are repeat one-liner questions. If you are not able to answer this question, it means that your preparation is not up to the mark. If you are eligible for upcoming NEET PG or FMGE or INICT, you should at least solve these frequently repeat questions. It is still time. If you are not able to answer this question, take a 1 month subscription of An Academy, because all the educators are going on with their rapid revision courses along with lot of MCQs which they will discuss during their live class. So please try to read along with us. Okay, so you all are right. The correct answer is mucosa. Please remember, it is absent over lips, absent over clitoris, as well as it is absent over external auditory meatus. Please remember, it is absent over the external auditory meatus. Reliable test for chancroid detection is skin test, biopsy, gram smeared or clinical examination. What is the reliable test for chancroid detection? Very nice. Sindhu, Uday, Neha Jabin, Venkateshan, Sarvesh, you all are right. Please remember, the correct answer is option number 3. On doing the gram stain, you will see a characteristic school of fish or a railroad appearance. Understood? You will see a school of fish or a railroad appearance. That is considered to be the most reliable test. Very, very nice, all of you. Pseudobubo is seen in what is that condition which will present with pseudobubo? Madhavi, Sindhu, Prince, Neha Jabin, Uday, Sarvesh, Arunima, everybody, I'm expecting this question to be right. This is a question from sexually active disease, one of the very important topic for any of the entrance examination. STD is a very important topic, requesting all of you to please read this topic as a whole. Okay. Very nice. So pseudobubo is seen in, the correct answer is donovanosis. Please remember, pseudobubo is a feature of donovanosis. Very, very important for each and every one of you to understand. Theek hai? Chalo, nice. Safety pin appearance is shown by Haemophilus ducre, chlamydia, donovanosis, mycoplasma. In which condition safety pin appearance is seen? इन विच कंडीशन सेफ्टी पिन अपीयरेंस इज सीन, हीमोफिलस ड्यूक्रे, क्लेमाइडिया, डोनोवानी ग्रैनुलोमेटिस और माइकोप्लाज्मा? एनीवन? वेरी नाइस अरुणिमा. व्हाट अबाउट सिंधु, सर्वेश, माधवी, उदय, नेहा? वेरी नाइस. प्लीज रिमेंबर, सेफ्टी पिन अपीयरेंस इज अ क्लासिकल फीचर ऑफ डोनोवाना ग्रैनुलोमेटिस. व्हाट हैपेंस, दीज इलोंगेटेड बॉडीज हैव अ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक staining of the end. So this bipolar staining is a feature of donovanosis or granuloma inguinal, also called as safety pin appearance or bipolar appearance, also called as donovan body, donovan bodies. ठीक है, सो प्लीज रिमेंबर ऑल दीज. यस, यू आर राइट प्रिंस. इट इज इवन कॉल्ड एज टेलीफोन हैंडल अपियरेंस. वेरी वेल डन. इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंडीशन कार्पेट टेक साइन इज सीन? इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंडीशन विल यू सी अ कार्पेट टेक साइन? लूपस पर्नियो, डिस्कॉइड लूपस इरिडिमेटोसस, डर्मेटोमायोसाइटिस और लूपस वल्गैरिस? इन विच कंडीशन कार्पेट टेक साइन इज सीन? लूपस पर्नियो, डिस्कॉइड लूपस इरिडिमेटोसस, डर्मेटोमायोसाइटिस और लूपस वल्गैरिस? वेरी नाइस प्रिंस, उदय, वेंकटेश, डॉक्टर माधवी, नेहा, सर्वेश. वेरी वेल डन. सो इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंडीशन कार्पेट टेक साइन इज सीन? रिमेंबर दैट द करेक्ट आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज डिस्कॉइड लूपस इरिडिमेटोसस. इन डीएलई पेशेंट्स because of the thickening. So what happens, suppose this is the dermoepidermal junction. In the patients of DLE, you have scarring and you have thick scales which are present. So you have thick scales. Now what happens, these scales, so suppose these are the hair. So these scales enters the follicular opening. Little bit they get entry into the follicular opening. So this is the follicular opening. They get entry into the follicular opening. So they will become somewhat like this. There is a blackish structure, that is the scales, and tiny pointed tooth-like structures coming out or projection seen on the undersurface of the scales. These are called as carpet tech sign or also called as cat tongue sign. Feature of discoid lupus erythematosus. I hope this is clear. The most common cutaneous manifestation in a patient of SLE is, what is the most common cutaneous feature of SLE patients? Very nice. Neha Jabin, Uday Venkatesh, Dr. Madhavi, Sindhu, everybody is right for this particular question. The most common cutaneous manifestation in systemic lupus erythematosus is chronic ulcers, malar rash, Raynaud's phenomena and photosensitivity. Absolutely right. So which of the following is correct? The correct answer is, please remember, answer is photosensitivity. It is not malar rash. I can see majority of you marking option number 2. But please remember, photosensitivity is the most common, followed by Raynaud's phenomena, followed by malar rash. Okay. The next question, what is Holster sign? And where do you see Holster sign? Sindhu, Venkatesh, Prince, Uday, Raj Ravi. Good. So Holster sign is seen in DLE, SLE, dermatomyositis or localized scleroderma. Very nice. Please remember, Holster sign is a feature of dermatomyositis. It is nothing but confluent reticular violaceous erythema of lateral thigh. ठीक है. So it is confluent reticular violaceous erythema of lateral thigh, which is called as the Holster sign seen in a patient of dermatomyositis. Now, chemical agent responsible for contact leukoderma caused by adhesive presence in the bindi. So what is that chemical agent which is responsible for the leukoderma caused by adhesive which are present in bindi? PPD, nickel, PTB or MBEH? The chemicals responsible for contact leukoderma. Anybody can answer this question. A very, very easy question. I feel that majority of you can answer this question. Very well done. Very nice. Sindhu Vijay, Deepika, Raj Ravi, Sarvesh, Dr. Madhavi. Very nice, everyone. So the chemical agent responsible for contact leukoderma, answer is PPD, sorry, the answer is PTPB, that is para-tertiary butyl phenol. Para-tertiary butyl phenol is the chemical agent responsible for contact leukoderma, which occurs in the adhesives of the bindi. Which component of cement causes allergic contact dermatitis? What is that component of cement which causes allergic contact dermatitis? Nickel, iron, cobalt or potassium dichromate? Nickel, iron, cobalt or potassium dichromate. Which component of cement causes allergic contact dermatitis? Anyone can answer this question. Nickel, iron, cobalt, potassium dichromate. Which component causes allergic contact dermatitis? The correct answer is option number 4. Please remember, cement consists of potassium dichromate, which is the most common allergen. It is not nickel, Raj Ravi. It is the potassium dichromate. What is the characteristic feature of atopic dermatitis? What is that one feature if present in a patient of atopic dermatitis, you have to answer it, or it, when it is absent, it cannot be a case of atopic dermatitis. So the question is, which is the characteristic or a hallmark feature of atopic dermatitis? That is what the question is asking. Pruritus, Denny's line, scaling of skin or rash? Very nice. So characteristic feature of atopic dermatitis is, what is the answer of this question, anyone? Very nice. Please remember, the answer becomes pruritus. Itching is the hallmark. It should be present for making the diagnosis of atopic dermatitis. Very nice. Which of the following statement regarding the diagnosis of bullous impetigo given below is false? So I think everybody knows that there are two types of impetigo or superficial bacterial infection. One is bullous impetigo, which presents classically with bulla formation, and another is non-bullous impetigo, which presents with yellowish or honey-colored crusting. The question is, which of the following statement regarding the diagnosis given below is false? Intraepidermal bullae are found, regional lymphadenitis is common, varnish crust is seen, or exclusively produced by Staph aureus. Which of the following statement is incorrect? Very well done. Sadaf, Uday, Venkatesh, Deepika, Dr. Madhavi, Raj. Very nice. The correct answer is option number 2. Option number 1 is absolutely true. Number 3 is true. And number 4 is true. But please remember, regional lymphadenitis is very common with non-bullous impetigo, not with that of bullous impetigo. The following conditions are seen as the complication of streptococcal impetigo except. Which of the following can never be seen in a patient of streptococcal impetigo? Scarlet fever, post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, rheumatic fever or erythema multiforme. The following conditions or complications are impetigo except. Very nice, all of you. Very, very nice. The following conditions are complication of streptococcal impetigo except scarlet fever, post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, rheumatic fever or erythema multiforme. The correct answer is option number 3. Please remember, rheumatic fever can never occur secondary to the streptococcal species which causes the impetigo. Very nice. Which of the following is a bacterial infection of the skin? Which of the following is the bacterial infection of the skin? Very nice. See, the pyoderma gangrenosum, it is a neutrophilic dermatosis. Pyoderma gangrenosum is neutrophilic dermatosis. Pemphigus neonatorum is a bacterial infection, that is bullous impetigo, another name, which occurs secondary to Streptococcus. So the answer becomes option number 2. Impetigo herpetiformis, what is impetigo herpetiformis? This is another name for pustular psoriasis. And ichthyma contagiosum is, yes, ichthyma contagiosum is the ORF viral infection. Is the ORF viral infection, that is ichthyma contagiosum. Very well done. I think everybody is clear with this important question of pemphigus neonatorum. Very nice. Which of the following is the correctly matched toxin with its target protein causing staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome? So which of the following is a correctly matched toxin with its target protein causing staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome or SSSS? Very nice. Raj Ravi, Deepika, Sindhu, Dr. Madhavi, Venkatesh, Sadaf, Prince, Uday. Very well done, each and every one of you. Please remember, the correct answer is option number 1. Staphylococcus excretes or releases an exfoliative toxin which goes and binds desmoglein 1, and that is why the level of cleft in a patient of staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome is subcorneal. Okay? The level of cleft becomes the subcorneal clefting. Coral pink fluorescence in the groin region on the Wood's lamp examination is seen in. In which condition you will see coral pink fluorescence in the groin? Erysipelas, erythrasma, erysipelas or ichthyma. Coral pink fluorescence in the groin region on Wood's lamp examination is seen in. Very well done, everyone. Very nice. Good. So coral pink color is a feature of erythrasma, which occurs secondary to Corynebacteria minutissimum. Corynebacteria minutissimum. Commonest skin infection in children is. What is the commonest infection of the skin in children? Scabies, impetigo, molluscum or warts? Very nice. Please remember, impetigo contagiosa, which is the bacterial infection, is the commonest skin infection. The bacterial infection is the commonest skin infection. Okay? Which of the following organism causes erythrasma? Which of the following organism causes erythrasma? Corynebacteria diphtheriae, Corynebacteria minutissimum, Corynebacteria teenius or diphtheroidus? Which of the following organism causes erythrasma? Very nice, each and every one of you. Remember, we have just now discussed this, that the answer is option number 2. We have just now discussed, okay? So, Corynebacteria minutissimum is a causative agent of erythrasma. So here I have discussed this question. Wood's light is used in the diagnosis of. So among the options provided, can you tell me Wood's lamp can be used in making the diagnosis of Tinea capitis, Candida albicans, Histoplasma or Cryptococcus? Very nice. Please remember, the Wood's lamp light is used in making the diagnosis of Tinea capitis. Why? Because the organism, which is Micrococcus, this organism have a capacity to fluorescence. It will become blue-green in color on or under the Wood's lamp. Okay? So I can see that majority of you are right. Please give me a thumbs up, each and every one of you, if you understood. Very, very important point for all of you. Okay? Chalo, nice. Wavelength of light produced by Wood's lamp is. What is the wavelength of light produced by Wood's lamp? 320 nanometer, 360 nanometer, 400 nanometer or 480 nanometers. Wavelength of light produced by Wood's lamp is. Wavelength of light produced by Wood's lamp is 320 nanometer, 360 nanometer, 400 nanometer or 480 nanometer. Please remember, I have told you a mnemonic to remember this. Can anybody tell me what is that mnemonic? So the mnemonic which you have to remember is the number of days in a year. Number of days in a year is the mnemonic to remember the wavelength, and you have 365 days. So the closest answer here will become 360. Otherwise, the wavelength is 365 nanometers only. Okay, so that becomes the correct answer. Wood's lamp filter is made up of tin and chromium oxide, nickel oxide and silicon, copper oxide and barium or zinc oxide. So Wood's lamp filter is made up of which among the following? Very nice. Tin oxide, chromium oxide, nickel oxide, copper oxide or zinc oxide. Please remember, the correct answer is the Wood's lamp filter is made up of barium silicate and nickel oxide. So option number 2 is the correct answer here. Erysipelas. Erysipelas means erysipelas like infection, which is transmitted by Erysipelothrix rhizoeopathy. What is the correct answer? Erysipelothrix rhizoeopathy. It is transmitted by droplet, parasites, mosquito or contact with the animal. Droplet, parasite, mosquito bite or contact with the animal. How is erysipelas transmitted? Very nice. Please remember, erysipelas is transmitted through contact of the animal. For example, raw fish or meat. So when these individual handles the raw fish, the organism gains entry into the palmoplantar skin, giving rise to development of erysipelas-like lesion. Now it occurs because of erysipelothrix rhizoeopathy. It is called as erysipelas-like because erysipelas occurs secondary to streptococcus. Which organism or which of the following organism causes ichthyma gangrenosum? Which of the following organism causes ichthyma gangrenosum? Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, Pseudomonas or Clostridium? Which of the following organism causes ichthyma gangrenosum? Very nice. Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, Pseudomonas or Clostridium. Please remember, the correct answer of this question is option number 3. Ichthyma gangrenosum is seen in debilitating patients, immunocompromised patients, bedridden patients where they develop deep ulcers with eschar over it, seen secondary to Pseudomonas infections. What is volcano sign and where do you see this condition? What is volcano sign and where do you see this? Oriental sore, lupus vulgaris, chromoblastomycosis or chorion? Very nice. Please remember, you all are right for this particular question. Volcano sign is the cutaneous lesion seen in the patients of oriental sore, Delhi boil or cutaneous leishmaniasis. Oriental sore, Delhi boil or cutaneous leishmaniasis, very very important for each and every one of you. Dermatophyte is infection to superficial part of the skin, dermal part, facial part or muscular part. What part of the body is affected in the patients of dermatomyositis? Dermatophytic infection are infection to superficial, subdermal, subfacial or muscular. Please remember, the correct answer of this question is it is infection of the superficial most part. Superficial means stratum corneum. Okay, so please remember, dermatophyte are the keratophilic fungus which affects the dead layer of the skin, that is stratum corneum. Which does not cause tinea capitis among the options provided? I hope you remember there are three species of dermatophyte: trichophyton, epidermophyton and microsporum. In this, please remember that trichophyton never affect hair, microsporum never affect nail, or trichophyton affects all three. Okay, so trichophyton, epidermophyton and microsporum. So which does not cause tinea capitis? The answer becomes epidermophyton, because E never affects the hair. E never affects the hair. Okay, dermatophytes are, so which among the following is an example of dermatophyte? Sadaf, Sindhu, Uday, Prince, Kik, Dr. Madhvi, please answer this question. Dermatophyte are sporothrix, tinea, vesicular, chromoblastomycosis or trichophyton rubrum. Very well done. So the correct answer is dermatophytes are trichophyton rubrum. I have told you there are three type of dermatophyte: trichophyton, epidermophyton and microsporum. But the correct answer given here is option number 4. Chromoblastomycosis is a deep fungal infection that is not dermatophyte. Please remember the pickup. Okay. What is black dot ringworm caused by? What is black dot ringworm caused by? Anyone? Very nice. The correct answer of this question becomes option number. The black dot ringworm is caused by, please remember, it is, the mnemonic is black and white TV. What is the mnemonic? Anyone? The mnemonic is black and white TV. So black and white stands for, B stands for black dot, and TV stands for trichophyton. Can you tell me what does TV stands for? Anyone? Trichophyton. T stands for tonsurans and V stands for violation. So trichophyton, tonsurans and trichophyton violations becomes the correct answer. So option number 2 becomes the correct answer. Very nice, Madhvi, Kik, Prince, everybody. Now the next question is here. Dhobi itch is, what is Dhobi itch? Can anybody tell me? Tinea corporis, Tinea cruris, Tinea barbae or Tinea capitis. What is Dhobi itch? Very nice. Dhobi itch is nothing but another name for Tinea cruris, also called as jock itch. Also called as jock itch, that is Tinea cruris lesion. So Sumati, Dr. Gibbon, everybody is right here. Tinea unguem is dermatophytic infection of, what is Tinea unguem? Yes, absolutely right. Tinea unguem is a dermatophytic infection of the nail plate. I have told you, dermatophyte affects the dead tissue. Dermatophytes affect the dead tissue and the dead tissue is the nail plate. Very nice. Oral thrush is also known as acute pseudomembranous candidiasis, chronic pseudomembranous candidiasis, chronic erythematous candidiasis or acute erythematous candidiasis. What is oral thrush another name for? Anyone can answer this question. Very nice. So oral thrush is another name for acute pseudomembranous candidiasis. You all are right. This is a characteristic case of acute pseudomembranous candidiasis. Please give me a thumbs up, each and every one of you, if you understood this point. Asteroid bodies are seen in sporotrichosis, chromoblastomycosis, mycetoma or dermatophytosis. Where do you see sporotrichosis? In which of the following part? Asteroid bodies are seen in sporotrichosis, chromoblastomycosis, mycetoma or dermatomyositis. Very nice. Asteroid bodies are the feature of sporotrichosis, while for chromoblastomycosis, the bodies are sclerotic bodies or medullar bodies, also called as copper penny bodies. Copper penny bodies. Okay? So sclerotic bodies, medullar bodies or copper penny bodies are the answer. Okay? Which of the following organism causes botryomycosis? Can anybody answer this question? Which of the following causes botryomycosis? Candida, dermatophyte, actinomycetes or very nice. Please remember. So which of the following organism causes botryomycosis? The correct answer becomes, see, this is a misnomer. Botryomycosis, mycosis means fungus, but it is a bacterial infection. It is a bacterial infection. It is thought that initially it was thought as it is a fungus because it resembles mycetoma. but clinically you have grape, you have round or grape like clusters of cocci. So this is a characteristic case of staphylococcal infection of the skin. What is a vagabond disease? Pediculosis corporis, scabies, eczema or ringworm. What is vagabond disease? Can anybody answer this question to me? Very nice, all of you. Can anybody else tell me the answer of this question? Good. So vagabond disease is an infection of or infection which occurs secondary to pediculosis corporis. Please remember, it is the infection of the body part, pediculosis corporis. Very nice. What about Pseudomonas? So in which question you are asking about Pseudomonas prince? With respect to which question you are asking me, please reframe it. Nodular scabies is seen in web spaces of finger, axilla, abdomen or scrotum. Yes, very nice. So what is nodular scabies? Because of excessive itching, patient keep on rubbing the lesion and they develop nodules in them. And the commonest site is over the scrotum. Understood. Please remember that the patient develop the nodules over the scrotum, penile shaft, anywhere over the genitalia. What is the most common type of cutaneous TB? What is the commonest type of cutaneous TB? Anyone can tell me the answer of this? Very nice. So I can see a lot of students with the correct answer. Please remember, the commonest type of tuberculosis cutaneous TB is lupus vulgaris. I hope you all know that vulgaris means most common. Lupus vulgaris is most common. It is not erythema multi, erythema induratum or scrofuloderma. Please remember, if they tell you that, or if they ask the question, most common type of cutaneous TB in children. If they ask you most common cutaneous TB in children, then the answer becomes scrofuloderma. Okay? Then the answer becomes scrofuloderma. The most common type of cutaneous TB is in children becomes the scrofuloderma. Tuberculid. Which of the following is a tuberculid? Which of the following is a tuberculid? Very nice. So tuberculid are seen in lupus vulgaris, scrofuloderma, lichen scrofulosodum or erythema nodosum. So please remember, you all are right. The correct answer is option number 3. Very nice, all of you. Fish tank granuloma is caused by which of the following organism? Which of the following organism causes a fish tank granuloma? Mycobacterium avium intercellular complex, Mycobacterium kansai, ulceran and marinum. Yes, so please remember, fish tank granuloma is Mycobacterium marinum, also called as swimming pool granuloma. Take care. Also called as swimming pool granuloma. So Mycobacterium marinum infection. Now slap cheek appearance is seen in, can you answer this question, all of you? Where do you see a slap cheek appearance? Erythema infectiosum, erythema or exanthema subitum, rubella or scarlet fever. Very nice. So please remember, this slack cheap appearance is seen in the patients of erythema infectiosum. Very important. The slack cheek appearance is a feature of erythema infectiosum. Option number one. All of the following is a feature of ichthyosis vulgaris except. All of the following is a feature of ichthyosis vulgaris except. Autosomal dominant, filaggrin protein is the target. Absent granular layer or flexures always involved. All of the following is the feature of ichthyosis vulgaris except. Very nice. So please remember, the correct answer is option number 4. It is an autosomal condition. This is true. Filaggrin protein is targeted. Absent granular layer, but please remember, flexures are spared in a patient of ichthyosis vulgaris. Very nice. Which gene has been recently linked to pityriasis rubra pilaris? This question we have done, I think, so many times. I want each and every one of you to please mark it. Dr. Madhavi, Venkatesan, Uday, Kik. Which gene has recently been linked to pityriasis rubra pilaris, not to CARD14, B27 or SOR1? Yes, it is option number two, that is CARD14 is the gene which is recently linked to pityriasis rubra pilaris. The Griffith classification is used for which condition? You will use the Griffith classification: psoriasis, lichen planus, pityriasis rubra pilaris or parapsoriasis. For which condition you will use Griffith classification? Very nice, Uday, Venkatesh, Sumati. Please remember, Griffith classification is again for pityriasis rubra pilaris. And I've told you yesterday that they have divided the patients into classical type, where you have cephalocaudal arrangement, and the atypical type, where the arrangement is other than cephalocaudal. Now, what is buttonhole sign seen in? Anyone, where do you see the buttonhole sign? DLE, von Recklinghausen's disease, tuberous sclerosis or ataxia telangiectasia? This is again a repeat question. We did it yesterday and day before yesterday only. It is a feature of type 1 neurofibromatosis, also called as von Recklinghausen's disease. Very nice. What is the pathognomic sign of neurofibroma? Gibson, Uday, Sumati. Very nice. Please remember, the pathognomic sign is not cafe olimacule, it is the axillary fractling. I have seen students getting confused in option number 1 and 2, but please mark option number 2 as the correct answer. Defective DNA repair is associated with all except. Anyone? Sindhu, Gibson, Prince, anyone? Defective DNA repair is seen in a patient of, please remember, xeroderma pigmentosa. Option number 2 is the correct answer. What is the mode of inheritance of incontinentia pigmentae? How will a patient of incontinentia pigmentae will have their inheritance? Please remember, incontinentia pigmentae, which occurs because of the Nemo gene defect, it is lethal to male child because it has an X-linked dominant mode of inheritance. It has an X-linked dominant mode of inheritance, which is very, 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 very important. Okay? Understood? Very nice. Which of the following is a true association? Which of the following is a true association? Very nice. So please remember, the true association is option number 2. Metabolic syndrome means obesity, high waist to hip ratio. Obesity, high waist to hip ratio. You have hypertension, diabetes mellitus, hyperlipidemias or hypercholesterolemias. All these things are associated with increased risk of cardiovascular accidents, and that is why this is a case, classical case of psoriasis and metabolic syndrome. So with this, we are ending the class, and we had discussed a lot and lot of questions. We have completed 60 questions in this 1 hour session. I hope all of you enjoyed it. If you like this class, please give me reviews. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, that is Let's Crack Neet PG. And please get a 1 month subscription using my referral code JSTAR10. So bye bye all of you. Take care, and we'll meet again tomorrow morning at